headlines on all the sports sections in New York. Mark Messier said, we will win game six. There's something about Mark Messier. It's almost as if he was genetically programmed to handle big situations.
They hadn't scored. They hadn't played well. The Devils looked like, they just looked like they were the better team, really.
Just basically, people didn't know what to think. They were just completely drained game after game. And of course, Messier said this thing where, you know, I guarantee that we're going to win.
There are a lot of guys that have big games when the season is on the line, when a series is on the line, but not too many tell you they're going to do it beforehand.
I'm ecstatic about coming to the Rangers. I think that knowing the team and seeing the team and the young players that they do have, I really feel that we have a really good shot.
You didn't have to be, you know, Lord Stanley of Preston to figure out that if you wanted to win a Stanley Cup, you had to have a guy like Messier running the team.
Mark Messier helped lead the Edmonton Oilers to 5 Stanley Cups. No franchise was more in need of his fiery brand of leadership than the New York Rangers.
What was happening with the Rangers at that time was that they had a pretty good team, and they were getting into the playoffs, and they'd get one or two series into the playoffs, and then something would happen.
If you're a Rangers fan during this generation, you have a lot of Gilden and Radner in you. It's like, it's always something.
They needed somebody who was a great player, but even more so, show us how to win.
I'd just come off 5 Stanley Cups in 7 years, so I really felt comfortable on what I felt was necessary in order to win.
In 1991, Messier would have been welcome on any team in the NHL, but the Rangers represented a unique opportunity.
I love the history of the team, original six team. I love the opportunity to try to win a Stanley Cup here. It just supercharged me to the point there that I couldn't see you playing anywhere else.
You think about it, there was quite a risk for him there involved. I mean, here's the consummate winner going to a franchise that had completely forgotten how to win.
There had been talks of Mark Messier coming to the Rangers, and all of a sudden he was skating in a pregame warm-up with the Rangers practice jersey on him. He was kind of skating by himself because everybody was in such awe that Mark Messier was on our team. And I remember looking across and going, that's Mark Messier. You know, he's going to be on our team tonight.
5-time Stanley Cup champion, wearing uniform number 11, Mark Messier.
Messier had been brought to New York to lead. And in the Rangers' first home game of the season, he was officially named captain.
Now this team is the real thing. And I'm not sure that the Rangers were the real thing before he got here.
When he came to New York, he came to a somewhat dysfunctional team, a team that hadn't won the Stanley Cup, obviously, since 1940. He's brought in as a savior.
As a captain and as a leader, you start to see certain things and what needs to be addressed. And then so it's just slowly started to unfold and take shape.
Mark's command of the other players just made every other player on his team want to win that much more.
Messier demonstrated that command early on when he found a discarded Rangers sweater on the locker room floor.
I remember him picking a jersey up and saying, hey, this is, you respect this crest. A lot of people have worn it before you.
And then really the sweater that you were playing for really meant something to me. And it should mean something to everybody. You should have the respect for that.
Personally, I never would have thought of it before, you know, but it's just a little example of the things that he taught all of us.
Behind Messier's leadership, the surging Rangers won the President's Trophy and instilled hope in the Garden faithful.
I think that during that year, there was a feeling that great things were happening.
The immediate success and the drama that he added, suddenly hockey started to matter again in New York.
He adopted the city, and the city adopted him. Nobody loved New York more than Mark Messier.
When Glenn Sather was building the Oilers, he had the great player in Gretzky to build around, but he needed someone who had a little bit of fire, a lot of physical ability, and Mark brought all of that to the team.
Become a legend by predicting that a team is going to win a playoff series. You don't become a legend by scoring an overtime goal. It's got to be a series of events.
Thanks to his father, Doug, a professional hockey player, Messier grew up with the game of hockey.
Before I even started going to school, I went with my dad to practice I was there at the rink, I was in the dressing room, I was watching them practice, and so I got an early introduction into the game of hockey.
A number of his coaches from when he was, you know, like 9 years old noted that he was an intense player and that he had this will to win.
There were many stories from when he was younger, when a team was struggling and he'd stand up in the locker room, start throwing things or start yelling. And then his father would come in or whoever the coach would come in and the players were so riled up, the coach didn't need to say anything but get back on the ice.
Back into the Hawks zone. Messier's gonna get there with a great speed. Messier cuts in for the net, shoots, he scores! Mark Messier chased after that loose puck like a lion after the last T-bone.
The Edmonton Oilers had a superstar in Wayne Gretzky. In 1981, Mark Messier joined the team and it took only a few seasons before the Oilers realized they now had another.
I would say in 1984, Messier came into his own and people started to recognize that he was perhaps as important to the Oilers as Gretzky was.
And I'll never forget the goal he scored where he skated through two Islanders defenseman and passed Billy Smith and scored on a breakaway in game three, and that kind of set the tone that the Oilers are going to win this series. After the game, everyone was talking about that goal, and Glenn Sather said, well, you just saw what Mark Messier can do at his best, and then we saw Mark Messier at his best for the next decade.
Mark Messier gets the first skate with Lord Stanley's hardware.
By 1988, Wayne Gretzky and Mark Messier had led the Edmonton Oilers to four Stanley Cup championships. But the truest test of Messier's leadership would come when Gretzky was traded to the LA Kings.
I promised Mess I wouldn't do this.
Well, it was a devastating time for us, but I guess we really expected each other to continue on because we had a responsibility to ourselves and to the people of Edmonton and to the organization.
So there's Messier in front. He's gone!
Nothing demonstrated his greatness more than what he did for the Edmonton Oilers after Gretzky got traded.
When he started to speak to the press now, some of the kind of young guy, kind of maybe country-ish traits were gone. Now he was completely articulate. He had this kind of political sense of what to say. He matured as a leader.
In 1991, Messier would not accept defeat as he led the Oilers to their fifth Stanley Cup.
Messier going in alone. Messier scores!
The Oilers are going to win another Stanley Cup here in Boston.
It didn't really feel any differently, but if anything, probably a little bit sad that Wayne wasn't there.
We went out and said, let's go win this one for Gretz, baby, and this is for you, Wayne, right here, baby, all the way. We love you.
That's really where people started to realize that not only was he important when Gretzky was there, but he's good enough to carry a team by himself.
What else was there for him to do there? You know, he won five cups. He had cemented himself as one of the greatest hockey players in history. It was time for something else.
We knew it was going to be a tremendous series against the Devils, and we braced ourselves for what we thought was our road to the Cup.
Mark Messier breezes by Chodine and shoots. He scores! Messier one-on-one against Weinrich. Messier cuts in. He's got it. He scores! Messier with a quick step shot, and he scores!
Mark Messier came to New York to win, and in 1992, it looked as if the captain had begun to teach the Rangers how to be champions. But there were still challenges to overcome.
Ranger fans were so accustomed to things going wrong that I think as great as that year was, and Messier won the Hart Trophy that year, as great as he was that year, there was always the sense that something was going to go wrong.
The second season turned out to be a lot tougher year. We didn't play well. We had a coaching change. A lot of people felt I was responsible for the coaching change.
And the Rangers kind of collapsed. They actually finished last in the division.
It's just been a miserable, miserable time for the New York Rangers.
You just thought it was, well, it's just, you know, it's the Rangers, you know? They can't, if he can't win here, well then, you know, maybe it can't be done.
There was a lot of ill feelings in the garden, a lot directed at me.
And late in the season, Messier was actually booed. Probably the only time in his entire New York tenure that he was booed.
The disappointment of the 92-93 season might have broken a lesser leader. For the captain, it emboldened him and fueled his desire to win.
Messier races to the puck. Messier gets there. He scores!
It galvanized the team and brought them together with a true purpose for 93-94.
Here comes Messier again.
had Mike Keenan as coach, and Mike Keenan is just win at all costs. And Messier was completely on board with this program.
If he did anything, he held everybody accountable all year long. And with a veteran team and some talent, that's oftentimes the only thing you really need.
The addition of Mike Keenan provided the missing ingredient in Messier's recipe for success. The Rangers went on to win the President's Trophy and breeze through the first two rounds of the playoffs, only to run into their arch rivals, the New Jersey Devils, in the Eastern Conference Finals.
You would have had to thought that if we're going to win the Cup, we're going to have to go through the Devils at some point. We're the two best teams that year.
To me, that playoff series is the best I've ever seen.
We went up 2-1 in that series and then lost two in a row to go down 3-2. The Devils were playing excellent, and we knew they were going to, and we needed to find, we weren't playing poorly, but we needed to find a way to play better.
There was a feeling among Ranger fans that this might be the end.
I think there's a natural inclination to just completely jump off it at a certain point. But then came the guarantee.
This was headlines on all the sports sections in New York. Mark Messier said, we will win game six.
I felt what a great idea it would be for all my teammates to read the paper, as we always do, and open it up and say that, you know, I really believe that we can go in there and win. But, you know, a slight overview on my part that I realized that 14 other million New Yorkers, and including the New Jersey Devils, were going to read the same thing.
I remember just laughing, you know, like showing the headlines and you know, look what you got us into now.
Despite the confidence Messier had instilled in his team with the guarantee, the Devils seized control of Game 6 and jumped out to a 2-0 lead.
The feeling of believing that the Devils were going to win the Cup before the Rangers was devastating.
You know, we came in there with all great intentions, but the Devils just had so much momentum on their side. They were at home, they had the chance to close it out, but Richter just held us in there and held us in there and held us in there. And sure enough, right towards the end of the period there, we scored a goal. We felt the momentum had completely swung to our side, even though we're down 2-1. And sure enough, we went on the third period, and it was a tale of two games.
Moving it over the double line, cuts to the slot, feeds Messier, backhands, he scores! Messier has tied it at two!
Leach drops it, Kovalev again, save on the rebound, score! Mark Messier gets his second goal! The Rangers lead 3-2!
We felt we had momentum, we felt we had them on their heels, we felt they were hanging on.
Stuff a legend, you know, to go out and get a hat trick and to play the game he did and to do it in the third period, and just, it's amazing.
Although Messier had provided the Rangers with one of their greatest moments, he still had to lead the team to victory in Game 7, a task more difficult than they could imagine.
The game was in the bag for the Rangers. It was just a matter of finishing off the last few seconds and then the gigantic celebration.
Driver blocks it, Marmer's on in, reaching center, stopped by Richter, the Devils score! They have tied it! The Devils have tied it with 7.7 seconds to go!
At that moment, I thought, despite all the confidence I had all season long that this was the season, that was the moment where I felt the curse came back to bite us.
It was tough, you know, we felt we had the game won, but maybe all the things that we had to overcome of the past history of the Rangers, hardened us for that moment.
I think it was Lowe and Messier that just kind of gave it a little sarcastic chuckle and just said, all right, here we go, back at it.
Whatever it was, we were able to go into the dressing room, shake it off, and continue on with our quest.
Metto goes for the puck. Metto around the net. Sweeps it in front. He scores! Metto! 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 The Rangers are headed to the final!
When you play seven games, you don't have a lot of time to get ready for the next series, and so, and I think Vancouver had a few days off. So when we hit that ice for the first game, we were in full form.
I don't think Vancouver was going to win that series, but throw in all the other things, Messier's leadership, the fact that everybody here wanted this so badly, and it seemed predestined almost by that time, I don't think they stood a chance.
Messier! Here it is!
was a tremendous moment for me personally, obviously, because I really came to New York with one objective, and that was to try to help win a Stanley Cup. What made it so special was that I was able to share that with so many people that had waited so long.
Even though he won five cups with Edmonton, I think the cup that he brought to New York is the one that he will be most remembered for.
Messier was the man who killed 1940. And for Rangers fans, that's what they'll remember the most.
I don't think you're ever prepared for that moment where you're in the middle of it, you know, and 19,000 fans are looking down, focusing their energy on you.
After having led New York to its first cup in 54 years, Mark Messier realized that repeating that feat was not easy. In 1996, the Rangers made another big move, reuniting Messier with Wayne Gretzky.
There was just that coolness factor of seeing them together again. You know, it was just exciting to know you had the greatest hockey player in the world and then one of the top five of all time, Ben Messier, on the same team.
They were, I think, concerned how I'd feel about bringing Wayne to New York and if I would feel slighted. First of all, I was taken aback by the question, but I welcome Wayne to come to the New York Rangers, and it was a dream come true for us to play here in New York.
After only one season with Gretzky in New York, Messier encountered contractual problems with the Rangers, and as a result sought a new challenge with the Vancouver Canucks.
He wasn't happy with management. He wasn't happy too much the way the team was being run. And then when the whole money thing came up, it was a real affront to him. And the Rangers drew a line in the sand, and they made a mistake, and they'll admit it.
I felt a little bit that the organization had turned its back on who I thought, obviously, was the most important player in my career. So I was angry about it, for sure.
The 3 years he spent in Vancouver, I wouldn't say they were wasted for Mark, but it wasn't where he belonged.
Well, leaving New York was tough. I didn't want to leave New York. I guess going out west took me to somewhere where they had to start over as well. And it could kind of get me away from New York and thinking about it and start something new.
In 2000, Messier literally buried the hatchet with Rangers management and returned to New York to take his rightful place as the Rangers captain.
Obviously, you know, it was time for me to move on, and New York was interested. And I relished the opportunity to come back and finish my career.
Unfortunately, the Rangers don't do terribly well in Messier's final years, but the fans don't seem to really care that much. They just want to have Messier back. They feel he's theirs. He belongs in New York.
With his connection to New York as strong as ever, it would be with the Rangers that Messier would cement his place in the NHL record books.
My father was a big Gordie Howe fan. He loved him. My dad actually went to training camp with him. He got up and close and personal with Gordie Howe. So I had a lot of respect for Gordie. Still do have a lot of respect for Gordie. Being in a position to pass him was a big thing for our whole family, especially for my father and myself, who held Gordie pretty high on a pedestal.
Though he had become a living legend, another cup proved too elusive, and it soon came time for the captain to consider hanging up his skates.
There was a feeling that that was his last game at the Garden, and fans were treating Mark that way.
Here's a chance with Bud Bellin. Messier scores! Mark Messier!
They were giving him one last cheer, one last ovation.
And they're on their feet at the Garden to cheer the captain.
I felt there was a real chance that it probably was my last game, although I wasn't kind of ruling out coming back another year. And I approached it like it was my last game because I didn't quite know. And it was an emotional night.
And the chance at Messier go up one last time.
And he realized this is it, this was the time. And that's when he went to center ice and bowed to the crowd.
One last bow on the big stage.
Messier left the game a hero to New York, and the city thanked him in grand fashion.
It was kind of like Mardi Gras, New Year's Eve, the Olympics and Super Bowl all thrown into one night. It was a big party.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
To me, it was just a celebration of a lot of people that are responsible for me putting me in that position.
Tonight's celebration was called the celebration of a captain. And I said, I'm not sure if it shouldn't be called a celebration of their garden faithful.
And it seemed to be that everybody was there that night to celebrate it there, which, you know, it doesn't get any better for an athlete. When I look at it there, it's just a streaming video of memories and thank yous to all those people.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
There was just this very special feeling in the building that was different from other retirements of jerseys. And I guess that's just indicative of how important Mark Messier was.
In 2006, the NHL introduced the Mark Messier Leadership Award, given to a player who exemplifies leadership on and off the ice. New York Ranger Brendan Shanahan was the inaugural winner.
To have the award named after me is obviously a tremendous honor because of what it stands for.
Mark is truly a leader in the community. He's truly a role model. He typifies what we know NHL hockey players stand for, and he is truly our captain.
It's an important award, especially for the young players coming up to know that they have a responsibility to the way they conduct themselves, not only on the ice, but off the ice as well, in their communities and in the areas that they visit.
Mark Messier is someone who personified the joy of playing his game.
When you see him holding up the cup, that is his signature. That's Mark Messier.
He was unsurpassed as a captain, the quintessential leader of all time.
I don't think you need to do anything but put winner next to Mark's name.
In the end, you know, the game's about winning, and trying to find a way to win was what it was all about.
One of the greatest players in the history of the National Hockey League, one of the greatest to ever wear a Rangers uniform, the captain, Mark Messier.